Who is this businessman and what do we know about what happened to him?
Well, certainly, Michael, it is a mystery that is unfolding here in Beijing and in Hong Kong, right out, as Amara describes, of the Four Seasons luxury hotel. Xiao Jianhua was in that hotel. He'd been living there for some time. According to a source, he was spirited out of that hotel along with his bodyguards and then taken to the mainland. Now, the assumption is somehow he's ended up here in the mainland because of questioning. We don't know what about. And this is one of China's richest men, a tycoon that has business interests and investment interests spread through many different areas of the financial circles and reported links to some of the richest and most powerful families in China. Now, of course, this is worrying because the Hong Kong police say they're investigating. The family of the tycoon initially put in a report to the police and then withdrew it, leading to suspicions that somehow this is all around the mainland Chinese authorities.
Now, of course, this all adds to the fears that we've heard. This isn't the first time something like this has happened. There are a lot of fears that the freedoms guaranteed under one country, two systems are being eroded, and Beijing is asserting a lot more control over the city-state.
Well, that's very true, and certainly there'll be worries in Hong Kong that this might point to, and I have to say might at this stage, to further erosions of the one country, two systems. Of course, within Hong Kong, they have their own set of laws that are enforced by the Hong Kong police, and it's against the law for Chinese authorities or Chinese police to come in there and operate unilaterally. The Hong Kong police say they are investigating. It really does remind one of the case in 2015 and 2016 of several Hong Kong booksellers that ended up being taken into the mainland and then showing up on state TV with at times forced confessions. This is a slightly different case, though, because Xiao is very connected to the ruling elite here. Michael?
Yeah, that, and there was that other angle to this, too. There was a front page ad that was published in a Hong Kong newspaper on Wednesday in which Xiao appeared to deny he'd been kidnapped. And, you know, it was an advertisement. I mean, it was quite weird. It's not him popping up and saying it. It was an ad that probably cost something like $35,000, and it just said that he was recuperating overseas. How's that being viewed?
Well, it is very unusual, but not unprecedented. And it sort of mirrors what you saw on social media from Xiao or from his holding company saying, you know, I'm a patriotic citizen, a patriotic Chinese. I'm a citizen of Canada, which he is, that I have certain rights. I'm just recuperating overseas. You know, in the past, this has been used sort of to muddy the waters, to indicate everything's fine when, in fact, everything is not fine. Mm. And to take a page out attributed to Xiao in that paper is certainly a pretty dramatic move. But until he surfaces, either here in China or in Hong Kong, we won't know exactly what happened to this billionaire. But it is certainly a mystery that will continue, I fear.
Yeah, curious case indeed. David McKenzie in Beijing. Thanks, David.